Chris here with Chuwi's new mini PC. This is their most powerful yet. It's called the RZBOX. Now this has the Ryzen 9 4900H, very potent APU, has Vega 8 graphics, 8 cores, 16 threads, maximum turbo is 4.4 GHz. It does come with 16 GB of RAM and dual channel, a 512 GB NVMe SSD, and you can also add another one too if you wish to expand upon the storage that they give you. Now, I'm not sure on the pricing yet, and Chuwi also advised me that this unit they sent out to me is not a final retail version. They're going to be changing the cooler to improve upon the thermals and the fan noise, because later on, as you see, the unit I've got here is not very good. But apart from that, the rest of it, a little bit of a spoiler here, is very, very impressive, the kind of performance we can get out of this Ryzen APU. And included in the box, you just get two things. This right here, which is a Huntkey brand power supply. That's a common brand, I've seen it a lot before, 90 watts max, and then our power cable, which is going to, of course, be dependent on the region you buy. So if you get an EU one, you get an EU plug, US, US plug, Australia, NZ plug, you get the idea. So the front of it here is plastic, this part here. We've got our power on button with status LED, separate audio in and audio out, 3.5 millimeter, Type-C port. Now this, unfortunately, is only USB 2 spec, so that's not great. And that's another USB 2 port. So it would only really be plugging in a keyboard or a mouse into these. Then on the rear of it, we've got our exit vents, all the hot air is coming out of here. DC in for our power, DisplayPort 1.3, HDMI 2.0A, and here we do have VGA if you actually needed that. Well, it's here. Two USB 3.0 ports, two USB 2.0s, and then two 1 gigabit LAN ports. And left and right of it, we just have this, which is plastic. So it's the middle, the top, and the bottom. Front and back is plastic. It has quite an industrial looking design to it. I don't mind it. I think it looks okay. Now, if you undo those four Torque screws on the back of it, you can then slide the top off and expose then the internals. So right here, we have a dust filter. So on the outside, it will eventually build up a little bit of dust. You could easily just blow that off or vacuum it off. And now our cooler right here. So this Chuwi has told me they're going to be upgrading the copper in this, the transfer heat pipes and the cooler itself, and also increase the BIOS from 35 watts on this review unit to 45. And unfortunately, I really wish I got the unit, the final retail unit, and not this. I really hate it when this happens. You can see there's a lot of spare space around here. They could have had room for a 2.5 inch drive, but sadly we don't have it with this. And we can see the location of the wireless antennas. So there is one here on the side and another one on the front of it, where the plastic is, so that is great, of course, for the best wireless antenna reception. Now, the wireless card, if you did want to change it, that Intel one, the Wi-Fi 6 card that we've got, it's just in there. You can just see it, okay? But you'd have to remove the whole heatsink and this fan assembly to get to that wireless card and swap it out. And exactly like the top, we've got this alloy, and I really do like it. It's almost like a heatsink, heat dissipating design that they've gone with, and it's in that matte gray. So if you undo all of the screws around the outside, which I've already done, you can then hopefully pry off, there we go, the bottom of it, and that then exposes our upgrades that are very easy to do ourselves to. Just add another M.2 NVMe drive right here. There is the NTAC, which is our boot drive and the drive they include. This is 512 gigabytes, and I'll give you the speeds later on in this review. And then our RAM, so 16 gigabytes in total in dual channel, and yes, it is running at the correct speed, which is 3,200 megahertz. So very easy to replace this if you wanted to, and then add more storage or upgrade our RAM. And here is our BIOS. So we've got all the advanced settings open to us. Now, this is great. Now, Chuwi did a strange thing. They sent out a 35 watt configuration to me with the BIOS. So what I have done to make sure it's just like the retail version, which will be 45 watts, so we've got the same performance, is I did go into the settings here. You go into AMD CBS, need to go then into the NBIO common options, and down here, SMU common options, and over to this. System configuration was auto, which was only 35 watts. So I have set it now to 45. Now you could even put it onto 54 if you wanted to do so, but I'm going to review it as is, as you would buy it. And there's another option here too, that under graphics configuration, if you wanted to change this, the Vega 8 configuration here, you can put it on to game optimized. And what that does is the 16 gigabytes of RAM, if you have that installed, will dedicate 2 gigabytes of the RAM just to the Vega 8. Now, if you happen to have, say, 32 gigabytes in this, it will then be 4 gigabytes dedicated to the Vega. And if you put 64 in, it'll then be 8, I believe. So that's how it works. But I'm going to keep that on auto, so everything really is as factory retail version as possible. So let's go into Windows now. This Chuwi RZBOX, it does ship with Windows 10 Home, but if you're thinking about upgrading to Windows 11, will it support it? It does, okay? We've got the secure boot, we have the TPM 2.0 that we need, it's enabled, and of course the spec of it, yep, definitely fine, not going to be a problem if you want to run that. Now, I won't be running Windows 11 on this because it ships with Windows 10 Home, so that's how I will review it. So we do have the Ryzen 9, the 4900H. It's a very, very potent chip here. Even though, okay, yes, it's last gen, it's still excellent. Now I did, as I showed you before with the BIOS, set it to 45 watts. Okay, that's what it will be with the retail version. Chuwi told me that the review unit is set to 35, so that's why I changed it to 45 there, as I explained before. So the RAM is running at, well, it shows 1600, but it's in fact 3200 megahertz, and those are the timings. CL22, typical for AMD, not great RAM timings, unfortunately. So we've got the Vega 8 graphics, 8 cores, maximum turbo is 4.4, and it's a 7 nanometer chip. Now, how does it perform? Well, this is just straight up here, the Geekbench 5 score, updated the drivers and everything too for it. And that is impressive. The multi-core score, very, very good. The single core, yes, the Intels tend to do a little bit better there. They can get around 1500, but very, very good. This is really fast. It's a potent chip, okay? So it's not a slouch. So general office tasks and everything will be very, very fast. Now, the storage they include with it is an NVMe drive, okay? You can see that the speeds aren't the fastest, no, for NVMe, but still, this NETAC 512 gigabyte drive is a lot faster than SATA 3, and you can add another drive, you can expand upon the storage, just make sure it's M.2, and it's the 2280 size of NVMe drive, okay? No point buying an expensive PCIe 4 one, because it will not be supported. The wireless card, Intel's AX200, this has Bluetooth 5 with it. It's very fast. I get transfer speeds of about 1.3, sometimes 1.4. It depends on your router. It must be, of course, Wi-Fi 6 because it is a Wi-Fi 6 card to get these faster speeds. But it still falls back onto Wi-Fi AC. You can use that if you don't have the newer tech with your router. The HDMI port on this, even though it's HDMI 2.0, it can do this. It can do 4K 120Hz connected up to my LG CX. Not a problem to be able to run that, but it is at 8-bit, as you can see there. But it was smooth, there were no glitches, there were no problems. So that's another positive there out of this particular machine. So Cinebench R23 shows us that it is very powerful, the Ryzen 9 4900H. Now, compared to newer gen models that I've checked out with the 5000 series, like the Ryzen 9 5900HX in the Minis Forum HX90 mini PC, that got 12,000 points. So this Chuwi gets 10,000. That is actually really good. So it's an excellent score here, and it's an absolute monster. It just shows you that this is super powerful. So there's no point me covering documents, video files, everything I threw at it, it plays just fine, okay? So in order to make the video a little shorter, I won't be showing you that, okay, just to cut down on it. Now, this is the bad part, and we have to take Chuwi's word for this, which really we can't. I do hope, and I've asked them, that they send me out a final retail version and not this, what you could basically call a prototype, because they told me they're going to change the heatsink, they're going to change the fan, because look at this. These maximum temperatures are crazy. It peaked at 110 degrees. This is after me pushing it very hard with Cinebench benchmarks, Firestrike, all of that, the gaming and everything, okay? So it's way too hot. I could not recommend this mini PC looking at that. Now, the maximum power use that I'm seeing right now from the wall, the socket, it is getting up to pulling a peak of about 84 watts. Here you can see about 58, but I'm talking total from the wall about 84. So really it's down to Chuwi to fix these thermals, and the fan noise, it's so annoying. It's a high RPM constant no matter what you're doing. Even if you're just in Chrome surfing or in Edge or gaming, there's no difference. The fan noise is bad, terrible. So that's another thing that they say they will fix in the retail unit. And just before I get onto the gaming performance, how does the Vega 8 in this APU perform? Well, really good. Look at this score. The graphics score here is getting right up there. For integrated, that's not bad at all. Now, the best I have seen for Night Raid, this is 3D Max Night Raid, by the way, is 20,000 points. And that was with the Iris Xe graphics in a Huawei laptop, and it had very fast LPDDR4 XRAM. That's why it got such a good, crazy score. But still, that's excellent. That's a good result. Very solid. Just like this here, Firestrike, for integrated graphics, being able to achieve over 4,000 points for our graphics score. That's great. That's just to show you really that the Ryzen 9 4900H, still very potent. And this score, it's not that far off the 5000 series, as mentioned, that 5900HX. And gaming performance, so this is Grand Theft Auto 5, medium settings, medium pedestrian variety, and the view distance, and also the density of the pedestrians here. And we're getting over 60 frames per second. Now, this performance right now, nighttime, is really good for integrated graphics. I mean, this is so close to the Iris Xe with the very fast LPDDR4 XRAM. So this is impressive. Now, note that it's holding the 1750 megahertz there at the top. So it's keeping that top GPU boost clock, and it's not throttling down the GPU. So the Vega 8 here is doing extremely well, and I really am impressed with this performance. So for light gaming, these older titles with low settings and maybe even lowering the resolution down, definitely possible here on the Ryzen 9 4900H powered RZBOX here from Chuwi. And finally, my Linux test. So yes, it is working just fine. The wireless AX200 card connects up to my network and not a problem there. Everything seems to load in just fine and no issues running your favorite Linux distros on the spec. And as you can imagine, the performance of it is excellent running Linux. Now, the final verdict from me, I cannot unfortunately give you right now because I don't have the final retail version. I really do hate it when companies do this, when they send us something that is basically a prototype to review and we're not reviewing the final product, which everyone is going to get. But if they can do what they say they're going to do, fix the thermals with that newer cooler and then the fan noise, and I would say then this is going to be a very good mini PC, one to shortlist to consider, definitely. But as it stands, I can't really recommend it yet until we see the reviews of the final retail version. And now I did ask Chuwi if they can send me out a final model of this so I can confirm myself if the thermals are going to be a lot better, because as it stands with this setup, which they cannot sell like this, so I kind of do believe they're going to fix it. They can't sell it like this, hitting about 110 degrees Celsius on that Ryzen 9. That is not good at all to see, but the APU performance, really great. So CPU, the Vega 8 graphics, impressive. The way it runs GTA 5 with such a good frame rate at 1080p, really good to see there. So we can add easily another SSD in this. You can swap out the RAM, upgrade it to 32 gigabytes if you wanted to, all the way up to 64. That is something else that's great to see. Build quality, well, we do have plastic on the back and plastic on the front. The frame around it is plastic, and then it has the alloy on the top and the bottom of it. I don't like the fact that we have a Type-C port that is crippled with only USB 2 speeds. That's not good. If they're going to give us a Type-C port, well, please make it at least USB 3 speeds. So that's disappointing why they have done that. So I hope they can change that in the final version, but I kind of doubt it there. So if they, as I mentioned, they fix that fan noise and the thermals, then this is going to be a fantastic mini PC if they price it right, which I don't know anything about yet. Pricing, unfortunately, because that information just isn't available yet. So thank you so much for watching this review, or I could probably, should actually call it a preview, shouldn't I, of the Chuwi RZBOX.